Hello guys, in today's video I'm going to show you how to replace o-rings on the lance Nilfisk G2, G3 or G4 lance. As you can see, I got on the table G3 wand and lance, and just for comparison G5 gun and G5 lance. We are going to replace the o-ring over here. As you can see, I put on the table the product number 126481125. The size of this o-ring is 9 millimeters by 2.6 millimeters and it's NBR 90SH. NBR stands for nitrile butyl caoutchouc. 90, it's the kind of a how hard the rubber is, and SH stands for shore. As you can see, this particular o-ring fits to many pressure washers and wands or guns, G2, G3, G4. You can stop the video, zoom in and check. The list is not complete. There are many more models for sure. So that's on this end of the lance. And on the other end, over there, you can't see it because it's inside. We are going to change Nilfisk lance low pressure nozzle seal, product number 126481109. This fits lance models G2, G3, G4. You will see it when I take it out, and on this lance low pressure nozzle there is an o-ring in front of it, or it's over here. And if you would like to change only the o-ring, the product number of this o-ring is 300 431 and 2. The size is 7 by 1.2 millimeters and it's NBR 90SH as well. As you can see, we are going to replace o-rings on that fits to G2, G3 and G4 lances. But just for comparison, over here you've got lance from G5, and I believe you can use these o-rings or lance low pressure nozzle seal for this as well. The only difference I see is only the G5 lance is for higher temperature, not 40 but 60 degrees, and it's not up to 125 bars but up to 145 bars. What we'll need is WD-40, silicone grease liquid moly. If you got one, nylon pick for taking out the o-rings. If you don't, the thin flat screwdriver will do, and one screw like this, roughly 4 centimeters long, is for the wood. First, we will change the ring on this side. I'll use the nylon pick because the advantage of the nylon pick is that you don't scratch or don't damage, whether it's a brass, single plastic like in this case. So what you have to do is just to take out the o-ring like this. That's it. And if you've got a new one, you will just put the silicone grease on the top of it, grease it a little bit, and then easily replace it with the new one. Easy, very straightforward, no big deal. On the other side of the lance, what you have to do is you have to just, first, there is a clip, metal clip, over here, and you have to push it out from the other side. That's the first thing that you have to do. Or maybe even better would be, and I forgot to mention it, because it goes even better if you use WD-40 and spray a little bit of it inside. And you can leave it stay it for a while and then do what I mentioned. Push out this clip, this metal clip, and then take it out like this. And the next step is that you will take this screw, this 4 centimeters long screw for the wood, and before, and you can screw it a little bit inside like this. Don't damage the nozzle. And before you start to pull out, you have to press this button as much as it is possible, down to the bottom. And then you can pull out the low pressure nozzle seal. As you can see, it looks like this. It's this part that I mentioned at the beginning, product number 126481109. And you can either buy whole part, whole this plastic part with the two O-rings on it. Usually the leaks appears when this O-ring is worn out. You can either buy whole part, and I believe and recommend to do it, or you can buy only the small O-ring over here, and it's product number 300-431-2. And but I checked the prices, and roughly all this part costs very similar to O-ring separately, so it doesn't make any sense. But it differs, it depends on country. So you can replace either this O-ring or whole part. Let's say we got a new part like this. So again, and you are going to install it. Again, you have to first take out this clip, metal clip, then push, and before apply silicone grease on this side over here and on the O-rings, both O-rings, and on this side as well. What you have to do is just press the button as much as you can, and then just to place it in and push it with something like this. That should be it. And it's there. Just place the clip back where it was before. And that's everything. Not a big deal, nothing complicated. You have it fixed. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and good luck.